Although we are kinky and although we have our bedroom identities and titles, it does not mean that that is the only thing we are. We have lives outside of that scene. Hey guys, I'm back, and keeping up with this month's theme of porn stories, I'm here to talk about my kink identity. I'm a switch. I've already spoken on my sexual orientation, which is bisexual, queer, but in the kink BDSM scene life, I am definitely a switch, meaning I identify as a dominant and a submissive in those situations. I think the scene that best exhibits this side of my identity is a scene that I did for kink.com's Upper Floor, where I performed with amazing queer performers Milka Halili and Maestro. Now the framework for the Upper Floor is that there are two female slaves that is servicing a co-host, and the other two main hosts are facilitating the kink play at work. All this is for the entertainment of the guests that are invited to the Upper Floor, because usually it's a dinner party setting or a brunch setting with fantastic food. Thank you, Chef Marcus. In this scene, Milka and I have been cast as the subs of the day, pleasuring Maestro, which is our male performer and male talent. But before we get to the penetrative P and V sex, there is a little competition among the subs. Now, knowing that I'm entering a scene being a submissive, I have certain ideas as to how I'll perform it, and also what parts of my personality, especially in the kink scene, that I'll be tapping into. As a sub, I'm very service-oriented. I'm very much determined to please my tops and my doms, and I'm super enthusiastic and bubbly. My subspace is triggered by very mindful acts of pain and also challenges. But when I am in this dynamic with another sub and there is competition in the air, well, my switch side and my dom side gets turned on. In the first act of the scene, Milka and I are in a bit of a competition to see who's gonna have a more dominant role among slaves. Now, in the hierarchy of BDSM in the Upper Floor, I really enjoy being the top slave because it caters to my desire to be a sub and also my desire to be a dom. Long story short, if you're of age, you can go buy the scene and check it out and see how that goes down. Although it's typical for submissives to just bottom in many play scenes, since I came out on top in regard to this pecking order of house slaves, I was able to top them. For those of you who don't know what topping and bottoming is, the top is the person who's doing the penetrating, and the bottom is the one who's being penetrated. What I really loved about this scene was the code switching. When I would address the masters and the tops of the scene, I would get to be really submissive. I would ask for permission. I would leave my actions in their control. However, when it came to interacting with Milka, I was able to be a dom to them. I was given the liberty to play with their body in a penetrative manner with me as the top and administer pain and kink play to this amazing human being who is being my sub. Really, the scene was the best of both worlds when it came to my switch identity. The only drawback with being a switch in scene in my experience is my pain tolerance. I also identify as a very sensual pain slut. My pain tolerance goes along with how much my body is in command by my tops, by my doms. But when I'm in the headspace of being a dom and administering pain, I'm really not in the proper headspace to have a very high pain threshold. So sometimes when I'm in scene and I'm being switch rather than just purely sub or just purely dom, my bodily limitations change because of where I am mentally and what I'm willing to take. Thanks guys for watching this week's video. I will be back next week exploring kinks and fetishes and all sorts of things that turn us on. And until then, leave a question, comment, or concern down below and I'll take a gander at them. Until then, bye. If you check out my other video, 10 tips for anal sex, the link is down below. You'll get to know how to clean out and prep for anal sex. But this is my personal journey to being able to have successful anal sex. So when I first started exploring this part of my body, it